On the fringe of a Munich airport lies the wreckage of an airliner, still smoldering from a crash in which 21 people were killed. Tragedy enough at any time. But in that plane were a group of young men who were almost the personal friends of millions. Manchester United, the finest soccer team Britain has produced since the war.
Near Munich, a fierce blaze marks the wreck of a British airliner. In attempting takeoff, it brushed some trees at the end of the runway, then dropped 60 feet into a house and a gasoline storage shed. 21 died in the crash. 23 more are gravely injured. A shocking disaster that has a doubly great impact on Britain, for on the passenger list was the Manchester United soccer team. National champions, they were returning from Belgrade after tying Yugoslavia's crack team in the European Championship competition. Headed for the semifinals, they were national heroes, every man. The twisted wreckage of this airliner marks the site of a national tragedy. It is for Americans as if the Milwaukee Braves had been aboard. A bitter loss to the world of sports, one that will long be mourned.
One cold and bitter Thursday in Munich, Germany, eight great football stalwarts conceded victory. Eight men who'll never play again, who met destruction there. Oh, the pride of English football, the flowers of Manchester. Mac Busby's lads were flying home, returning from Belgrade. The great United family eats masses of their trade. The pilot of the aircraft, the skipper, Captain Thain. Three times he tried to take off, and twice turned back again. And the third time down the runway, disaster followed close. It was ice upon the wings, and the aircraft never rose. It smashed into the marshy ground, it broke and overturned. And eight of United's lads were killed as the battered aircraft burned. Roger Byrne and Tommy Taylor were capped for England's side. Ireland's Billy Whelan and England's Geoff and died. Mark Jones and Eddie Coleman and David Pegg also. Before the blaze and wreckage went a ploughing through the snow, a train, a coach and a secretary and a member of the crew, also eight sporting journalists who were the United flew, and one of them big Swifty we never will forget. The finest English goalkeeper who ever graced the net. Say that Duncan Edwards died with injuries to the brain. They say that Jackie Blanchflower will never play again. And the great Mac Busby lying there, the father of the team. 9 months or more will pass before he sees another game. Oh, England's finest football team, a record truly great. A proud success is mockened by a career well to its fate. Eight men will never play again, who met destruction there. Oh, the pride of English football, the flowers are